Hello everyone, panicCoffee here, and this week I have another figure to unbox.
Computer, coffee for two.
This is a character from Persona 5. So you probably know him if you've already been playing Persona 5. He's the protagonist in the game. He has many names though in the adaptations. In the Dancing All Night, he's Amamiya Ren, as well as the animation. In the video game, you could actually change his name to whatever you want. So this is simply his Kaito mode. He doesn't have his casual clothes or anything, he's just the mask. What's nice about this figure is actually you have a small version of Morgana. You can pose him with. This is a signature scene from the video game once you've survived a battle. Once you finish the battle, he always has this kind of stance. That kind, you know, with Morgana on the side. With his dagger and the mask. Well, here you have him unmasked. So, without further ado, let's unbox this baby. The figure itself. Oh, nice, well detailed. Be careful with those folds. So each individual flap has its own plastic to protect it. Nice. Let's take a look at Morgana or Mona. Whoa, okay, that's great. It's just a static figure. You can articulate his head. That's nice texture over there. He has actually the fluff in his ears. And yeah, still pretty well detailed. Really looks like her, like Mona. And this is your mini stand for Mona. He only has five extra hands. Okay, so nothing's missing so far. Yeah, that's an extra joint there in case you break yours. It's this, in fact. So that actually could break if you insist too much or if you pull on it too hard. So that's pretty nice. Good job, good smile. Let's lay it on the table so I can show you all of the parts. So there you have all the pieces. So don't be alarmed if you see three vacant pegs over here for the hands. I think the reason for that is they only gave us really five hands simply because we have an extra figure. So this is where I think the extra plastic went. As usual, the standard, two extra faces. Three extra faces in total. The weapons that they use in the game. The stand. So the stand both for him and Morgana. I really love how detailed they could make the faces and how expressive they are. I mean, look at this. Only thing I would say with the jacket is I wish they had added a bit, maybe a bit more color, maybe a bit of gray, just to lift up the, just to show more contrast in the black. A good sculpt will always show light and shadow with lighting, with proper lighting, so shouldn't matter as much. So let's try a few poses. So that was the Figma of Joker from Persona 5. It includes this cute little Mona with it. It's a static figure, but it's a nice accessory for any Figma of this universe. And I love the articulations. It seems it's the new version of Figma where they could actually... There is an extra joint, I suppose, here where you can push up and down. So they could actually sit down completely. This one might be a bit difficult because of the short sleeve. It's flexible. He could sit down. Okay. So I love that in the newer Figma. While in the old one you cannot really bend them like this. When you do, their leg starts to pop off. So thank you again for watching. I hope you enjoyed this unboxing. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I will see you next week.